Blessings. All right. Sorry if the hair and all of that stuff is crazy. It's a Saturday. I was going to do a whole vlog on a day of writing, which was being sponsored by one of our writing communities for Nanowrimo, National Novel Writing Month. It started at 9 and went to 4, and it was at the State Library. Last time I participated in this event, it was at our Big Ten school, Michigan State University's football field, in the stadium, like in the box seating or press box or something like that. It was so wonderful. It was wonderful. And it was just a ton of us writers, all from the area, that got together to write together. Yes, I'm repping my baby girl's TSU. She goes to TSU, so I'm repping her today. I'm trying to be comfy in my writing mode, but I haven't done much writing at all. My husband needed a car, so we had to go and look for one and see what's out there. It's hard to buy a car when you got 4 kids and 2 in college, 1 headed to college. Just the expense of it all is crazy, but we tried, which threw a total monkey wrench into my day. Now I'm at a limbo. I don't really know what to do. Should I start? I still gotta make dinner. Just totally messed up my whole little writing day. I was gonna spend the whole day just being a writer, and now I've spent the whole day being a mommy, cheating on keto because I've been a little stressed out. So I went to go get some nuts and things to make some keto snacks, and it didn't work. But we shall begin where we are. If you are writing, two tips for if you're writing, National Novel Writing Month, NaNoWriMo. Keep going. No matter what your goal is, if you write 1 word or 1,000 words today, if you write 1 chapter or 10 chapters, just keep going. Dream your dreams through action. So keep going. Keep doing the thing. So my first tip is wonderful teas. I'm a tea drinker. Coffee, bitter. I don't drink coffee at all, but I am a tea drinker and I love teas. So one of my favorite things, and I will be doing Vlogmas and talking about gift buying ideas for the writers in your life or future authors in your life. And so this is one of my favorite things. If they will sponsor me, I would love it. Harney and Son's Fine Teas. They come in these tins. Oh, I love them. They're adorable. Very cute. Very, very cute. My absolute favorite is this Hot Cinnamon Sunset. Oh, my goodness. Takes you to another place. Hot Cinnamon Sunset. I also have Hot Cinnamon Spice. I love that one. This one is the English breakfast. I'm a big English breakfast tea girl. Wakes me right on up. And then this one is new. I just got it. Green tea with coconut. I love coconut. I'm a joy girl right here. So I'm excited to see how that is. But I love that they're these tin cans. They're really nice, really cute. So great, 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 great writing companion. Harney and Son's Fine Teas. Great writing companion. All right, I'll be doing more on little things like that. But then here's your writing tip. So if you're writing, right now my character is in trouble. My main character, Keela, is in trouble. Big trouble. He's been in big trouble since probably page 2 of the book. And he keeps making really bad decisions. I like that. I like reading. I read Native Son, and I've read it before when you're in the whole college grind getting a degree in English. But then I read it recently, maybe 2 summers ago. And I read it as a writer. And I love the pacing. and the drama of making bad decisions when you're in trouble. When a character's in trouble and they continue to make one bad decision after another that immerses them deeper into the trouble, that draws a reader in greater and greater and greater into your story. So, pacing. Think about pacing. Pacing is how the story moves along. If you are writing for young adults, the books have to move. They have to move. And I struggle with this. I'm really challenging myself with this book to understand pacing and how to move the story along. But think about that with your book. What can you do with your characters to make that pace speed up, to immerse them quicker? And what I really like to do is I call it drown them. So I will dunk my character, especially my main character in trouble. I'll dunk him under that water, immerse him, and he's drowning with his decisions, with his actions, he's drowning. And then I'll lift him up and let him get a breath of fresh air. And the reason why I'm letting him get a breath is because when he gets a breath, my reader is able to get a breath. And my reader is able to not have that emotional, I gotta go, I gotta keep reading. But just enough, only long enough to dunk them back in again. So that's how I create my pacing, is I look at the decisions my character has to make, and I make sure he's probably not making great decisions. I want my readers to say, no, why would you do that? I want my readers to talk to my characters, don't go in there, go the other way, or don't make that deal, that's a bad deal. I want them talking to my characters, and I want my characters to be immersed in the trouble, to figure out a way how to get out of the trouble, but ultimately, I need to not kill my babies, because if I kill them, then I'm stuck. But I need them in so much trouble that my readers are screaming at them. So that's how I do it. I dunk them and I try to drown them. I dunk them underwater, and while they're flailing and fighting to save their lives, they're making one bad decision after another. And then I lift them up, give them a breath while I'm trying to fill in maybe some setting, some imagery, some backstory, some mind thoughts, so that my reader can breathe. My dog always decides, I haven't barked at all today. I get on video, she wants to bark. That's my life. So yes. Dunk your characters, immerse them. What kind of trouble can you put them in that, yeah, they can make decisions, but don't make the decision easy for them to get out of. Let them make bad decisions and pace that so that it's suspenseful enough, intriguing enough, thrilling enough that regardless of what you're writing, regardless of what genre, if you're writing romance, if you're writing mystery, if you're writing historical fiction, if you're writing realistic fiction, mine is realistic fiction, if you're writing science fiction, if you're writing fantasy, if you're writing speculative, all of those genres, your characters need to sort of be immersed in drama and trouble. That causes your reader to cheer for them or root against them or just have a desire to see what is the end result of this. How are they going to get out of this? Are they going to survive? When will they stop making these bad decisions? All of those thoughts is what drives us as readers. So think about that in your NaNoWriMo National Novel Writing Month pursuit. I'm cheering for you. I'm rooting you on. I'm hoping you get in all the words, even in the midst of buying cars, making dinner, cleaning your house, decluttering, raking leaves, changing over the season, buying new furniture. In the midst of all of those activities, I still hope you are able to get all the words in. And remember what we're living, choose to write all the wrong words until the right ones flow. All right, have a great NaNoWriMo Saturday. Blessings, and I'll talk to you next time.